to.
Maybe they'll send the JV and just give us an out.
So Leonard has already thrown out one runner. You mentioned last year was 1,000% throwing out runners.
Last year it took everybody a little while. There were some slow learners last year.
Wearing around the bunt, as if with sacrifice. She bumps it, pops it up, and does, makes the catch.
A great play, Georgia.
Oh my goodness. Georgia Land is up and ready for that
one. Girl, George.
And go head first into the fair
next up for Coffee County, number 23, Tori Bell.
Retire the hitter
from
the
way.
Hey, I'll be honest, the base runner had to do a great job and not get doubled up right there, because the way that ball was running, even though it was popped up, it looked like there was nobody to make that play.
Georgia had to run around the right-handed hitter to make the play. First pitch to Bell is slapped foul out of play. 0-1 the count. It's like a heavy bat for Bell. Tall player.
Yeah, she is. She's a solid hitter. All these kids here, Coffee County's got a lot of athletes. And when they stand in there, there's no weak spots in their lineup.
Pitch from Birdieshaw, all speed is high. And the count even at 1-1.
Flip or change up there. That's her weakest pitch. I talked to her a lot about before she goes to UNA, she's going to have to work on her change up. Her change up is not where it needs to be. She doesn't use it a lot because of it, but every now and then she'll show it to me.
1-1. Swing and a miss. And a high riser. And
nice ball there.
1-2 the count. Tori Bell, the hitter, first baseman for Coffee County. Tied at 2 in the bottom of the fourth. Coffee County, the home team on the scoreboard. Playing tonight at Jim Chance Field, side of the 8AA District Tournament. There's bracket final. Pitch is high, and we're even at 2-2.
I wish we could get Gracie Judkins to move more towards center field. She's too far to the right, big gap in right center, but I think she's got her spot marked out there, and she don't move off of it too much. She just kind of runs to the same spot.
2-2 coming. Line and long, but foul.
That's a long, hard strike.
Tori Bell.
Macy this year, she's had a tendency to give up the long ball. She throws pretty hard, and a lot of times she lets that fastball find the middle of the plate too much. You throw hard and you get in the middle of the plate, sometimes it finds its way to the parking lot.
This one again, lifted high and deep, but foul as Bell is out in front.
This is right here, JP. This is where she struggles not having a good changeup. The kid's out front on two straight fastballs. She's yanked them foul about 300 feet. So if she had a good changeup right here, she could really just slow her down and probably get it right here. She just struggles with a changeup. I wish they would at least try it anyway.
2-2 is high and outside, and we're 4-3-2.
She just doesn't trust it. She just doesn't trust it.
What do we see here, Corey, with a 3-2 count?
She's probably going to go with a rise ball. She's going to go with a rise ball probably, or she's going to go with an inside fastball.
Three and two, runner at first, one out, bottom of the fourth. Yeah. Drive three. Got her looking.
Okay, that was a great pitch. All the inside fastball right on the knees. She got her. She froze her with that. One of the things that Georgia
next up for Coffee
did,
County,
last night,
number 15, Kaylee Skipper,
that's
two down.
Brian's camera here that he records all the games with, and I know last night Georgia and Macy got together and watched the game from here, so they studied and seen what they did with the pitchers here, and that way they knew the game plan. And
Kaylee Skipper, the pitcher for Coffee County, takes a strike on the outside edge, first pitch 0-1. Runner at first for Coffee County, Katie Rutledge. There are two outs in the inning. We're tied at 2 here in the bottom of the fourth, Lawrence County and Coffee County.
You see right here the tool Georgia is, because most teams, she's already going to try to go. In a tie game, she's going to try to get in scoring position. There she goes.
Throw it down in time and got another one.
Slow JP.
Not even close. Georgia Lynn ends another inning, getting out of runner at second. So we head to the fifth. We're tied at two. Lawrence County and Coffee County, the AAA Winners Bracket Final here on the X Sports Radio Network. That's incredible.
She's got a command. And she's got such a quick release. Yeah. And, you know.
Taylor, you can go two spots here. Two spots. Taylor, after this commercial, just hit, I think there's a Home of the Lady Cats ball. Should be top line of your hotkeys, about halfway over. Home of the Lady Cats bump. Not the open, but the bump. See if that one will work for you. Doing a great job, by the way. Your score as we head to the top half of
the fifth.
Georgia Lynn retires another runner attempting to steal to end the inning. Second one tonight. Coffee County Lawrence County.
Leading off for the Lady Cats to the center fielder, number 8, Maddie Egley.
Followed by the Rose sisters, Callie and Brinley, to lead things off here in the fifth inning. JP Plant Cordero Show with you. Jim Chancefield on the campus of Lawrence County High School.
These two. Sue Rose is Callie and Brittany are actually first cousins. It's Callie and McKenna that are
McKenna.
Sisters. Yeah.
Okay.
McKenna,
thank you very much.
McKenna is a senior, Callie a freshman, so I'm sure when other people see the lineup card and see three Rose kids on there, they think it's fair.
There's a bump. It is fair. And safe at first. Maddie Egley leads things off with a nice little bunt down the third base line here at the top of the fifth, and the lead runner on for the Lady Cats.
Yeah, that's a great point, actually.
Now batting for the Lady Cats, the designated player, number 24, Callie Rose. Nobody else.
Callie right here, she needs to do her
job. Cap.
She needs to skip the ball on the ground. Let's move, Manny.
Hey, just do your job, Cap.
She puts the ball on the ground, so just like that.
She does. Slap bunt. And barely makes it to first. Stretching was the second baseman for Coffee County, doing a nice job there. And the runner moves up to second base. And that'll bring up Brindley Rose.
And you see the tool that we have in speed. She plucks that ball directly right back to the pitcher.
Now batting for the Lady Cats, the third baseman, number 13, Brindley Rose. Got one away.
Brindley coming up right here in a big spot. She needs to bring her surprises. She's not very big, but she can absolutely.
First pitch inside for the ball, 1-0.
When she gets a hold of one, she hits one on a line shot. She'll tear somebody's mask off.
So one of three Rose in the lineup, and I appreciate you being here, Corey. Keep me straight on all these family associations with all these softball players. There's a strike of the outside edge. Hope folks will be patient with me today.
I'll be honest, if we have an unfortunate, most all these girls have been around playing the travel balls for years, and I've coached three of them for 7 years, and there's a couple others that, my niece Macy and George, I've been around a lot, so I've been around a lot of these kids. And
1-1, strike of the outside
edge. I like Brindley.
Brindley Rose now faces a 1-2 count. The runner at second, though, is Egley, who led off the inning, was sacrificed over.
Hey, don't do good.
1-2, outside. Go down to second. Nobody's there. Oh, wow.
Everybody.
The catcher for Coffee County, Cumberland. There was the ball beat the runner back to second, but there was nobody there.
That's right. They just gave us a gift right there. She just she threw it. Nobody was there. And Brindley needs to. We got her at third base now. And we need to We need to score this run out here. One out.
Eggly's at third. Time called as Brian Lane wants to talk to Brenda Rose. While he does that, interested in purchasing photos of Export Station athletes in action, visit MacBrownPhoto.com or find them on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Mac Brown Photographers, the official studio for Export Station and all three high schools in Lawrence County. Mac Brown Photographers, creating tomorrow's memories.
I realize Brindley just put in play.
I'm sure. I know. I can imagine the conversation Brian was having with Brindley about just be patient, get the ball on the ground, and give us an opportunity to score. Interested to see how the defense is going to play. It looks like they're kind of inching up right here. It wouldn't bother me one bit if we hit about a 42 hopper to the second baseman and scored this run.
There is just one out. Brindley Rose with a 1-2. Little blooper, but it goes foul. Hit off the inside of the bat, moved towards first base, and we'll do it again.
Hey, here we go, Brandon. Work hard right here.
It is 2-2, yeah.
She's probably not going to see a strike. She's probably going to see a change up.
Here's the pitch. Swing, but it's fouled off. Fouled off and popped off everybody's mask, and we'll do it again. We just got a piece of that one.
What a hang, Brent.
That could almost work in my favor, JP. If she hadn't fouled that off, she could have hustled on down the first and got an extra one right there.
First base is open. Matty Eggly is at third, led off the inning with a single, a bunt single. Moved up to second on the sacrifice and over to third on the throw down to second that made its way into center field. There's one out in the inning. Here's a 2-2.
There it is. Take.
And it's down. They're on the score. Last
count is three.
Now we're on a single from Brindley Rose.
Big spot.